memories of time with my grandmother? Was it not recording this whole time? Oh. So I have some memories of making this with my abuela when she was living with us, and then she moved like with another family member. So I didn't have a whole lot of time with her, but this was some memories that I have of making this during like my August birthday month and having it kind of by the pool with her. And yes, it was just, it's something very special to me because like very few things that I have with my abuelita, and this is one of them, along with some a few other dishes, but mostly I've learned that from my father, I'm learning it from her. So this is just one I really wanted to share with people. I know it's probably some of the easiest things that you can do when it comes to cooking and not like that much cooking involved, but I just wanted to share a little bit of something that I had with my abuela. And for anyone who doesn't speak Spanish, abuela is grandmother. I'll see if Daisy can translate all that because I was just kind of going on.
Okay. So hoy vamos a estar cocinando con Chef Jessica y nos va a compartir una receta de horchata que ella aprendió de su abuela. Y es una de las como cosas que le quedan todavía de recuerdos y de que ella se acuerda que su abuela le hacía y tiempo que ella compartió con ella. Y la horchata, para los que no saben, es una bebida que se hace con arroz. Y es muy tradicional, pero hay muchas maneras de prepararla y elaborarla. Y depende de tus preferencias y puedes usar muchos ingredientes como la leche de almendra. Puedes usar agua también. O sea, todos tienen su receta y hoy la va a hacer para nosotros.
Great, thank you, Daisy. And so, yeah, I'm going to go ahead and start kind of making it. And thank you for joining me today. Again, if you have any questions, feel free to put them in the chat at any time. I've got several people that are on this call with me to help me with any questions that you may have. And then feel free to share any memories that you have of if you've ever had this drink or if you've had it with any family members. I think this is like a very good staple for the Mexican-American kind of household. Thank you. All right. Hopefully everyone can hear me all right. So I'm going to start making the prepping it. So there are kind of two ways. Do you hear me all right? Awesome. Okay. There are two ways that people make these horchata. And so first thing you're going to want to have is your long grain rice, your white rice. And the two ways that people do it is that you can rinse your rice first, which I know everyone's told that you need to rinse your rice. I don't do that because technically rice isn't dirty, which is a misconception that a lot of people have when it comes to washing rice. You're actually washing the starch from the rice or like rinsing it, so it's less starchy. I don't mind that in my drinks. I don't wash it, so I'm not going to do that. So if anyone comes at me for not washing it, I'm just going to state that first. And I'm just going to be using this.
Okay, so dejen traduzco. So el primer ingrediente y el más importante que van a necesitar es el arroz blanco. Y hay muchas maneras de hacer horchata y mucha gente prefiere lavar su arroz. Jessica no le gusta hacer eso. El arroz está limpio que compras de la tienda, so no hay que limpiarlo, por decir. Y cuando lo estás enjuagando, nada más estás lavando el starch. ¿Cómo se dice starch?
Starch.
no es requerido, pero si tienes esa preferencia, lo puedes hacer.
Awesome. I tend to forget that I'm being translated as I'm going. Okay, so first step is that we are going to want to measure out some of your rice into your cup or bowl. Generally, there's like a nice kind of metal bowl is a good one to use, but I've just used anything. I don't feel like there's much of a flavor difference, but I know some people do say that there are. The recipe that I have says about 2 cups. Gosh, this is gonna happen a lot. I'm so sorry if you see us go dark. Okay, so I'm just going to start measuring out some of the rice. I kind of just eyeball it, but 2 cups is generally a good amount for however much you're going to want to make. And so you just pour.
So primero Jessica va a usar como más o menos 2 tazas de arroz y las va a poner en un contenedor.
Okay. And you're going to have your almonds too. So almonds are going to help grind up too and give like the almondy flavor. So you're going to want a good mixture of like rice and almond flavor along with some of the other stuff. I do about like 1/2 cup of almonds to 1 cup.
Y el contenedor va a agregar como 1/2 taza de almendras.
Okay. And this is just something that I do. I just add a little bit of ground cinnamon to my mixture to kind of like get the flavors in with the rice.
Y también le va a añadir un poquito de canela molida para el sabor.
And I would say that's about like 1 tablespoon.
Como 1 cucharada aproximadamente de canela.
Okay, and then so I have these really long cinnamon sticks. So I'm going to break some of these up. So you're going to want to have your cinnamon sticks also in with your rice mixture.
Y también va a añadir 2 canela entera, so 2 palitos.
Let's see if I can break this one.
Jessica, are they whole almonds? Son almendras enteras?
So I have them already chopped up. So I just have a bag of like the sliced almonds. But you can do whole almonds. I would say try to get them without the casing. So I think they're called like blanched when they don't have like that brown around them. Skin, I think that's the word, almond skin. So that's kind of what you want to go for so it's not as textury.
So no son almendras enteras, ya están partidas. Y también recomiendo usar las almendras que no tienen la cobertura café, que ya están, en inglés se dice blanched.
Okay. Pardon me. Okay, so you're going to have your almond, your rice, your almond, and your cinnamon in your mixture here. And then you're just going to add water to this. So I'm going to fill it up to probably about the top of it. So I would say this is about, you want to put twice as much water as you have rice. So I'm going to pop over here real quick and put some water in.
So ahora ya que tiene todos los ingredientes juntos en el contenedor, va a agregar agua. Y necesita como... Tienes que cubrir todos los ingredientes y recomienda que tengas doble la cantidad de agua que tienes de arroz.
Okay, and it's gonna look a little like this, a little like your forbidden water. You probably don't want to drink it right now. And I am going to just kind of give it a quick stir so the water kind of goes all the way around. So this is probably the most time consuming part of making horchata because you're going to want this to sit overnight. I do about like 8 hours, sometimes like 10 to 12, but you can do 6 hours, but the goal is to get the rice soaked in with all of this flavor and all of this water. So it kind of thickens up and it makes it easier to blend because then it gets a little too chunky. And this is where we get the kind of liquid for the horchata. This is your base.
Okay, so ahora está mixtiendo todos los ingredientes juntos. Quiere que la agua se vaya hasta abajo del contenedor. Y recomienda que pongas esta mixtura a remojar, preferiblemente toda la noche. Ha hecho como 8 horas hasta 12 horas. So, es de preferencia y de tiempo que tengas, pero sí necesita remojar por muchas horas.
Okay, and then so you're gonna want to store this in your refrigerator overnight. So I'm gonna go pop this in our refrigerator and we will pretend that this has been here overnight. I'm gonna win.
Okay, y cuando ya tengas todo mixteado, lo vas a poner en el refrigerador para que se remoje toda la noche. Y Jessica preparó la mixtura en anticipación. Si eso es lo que están viendo ahí, ya lo tienen listo para que no tengamos que esperar 8 horas.
Okay, so this has been in the fridge overnight. I'll come close to the camera if you really want to see kind of how it looks. It still pretty much looks the same, but the rice has kind of gotten a little thicker.
We don't listen.
No, we can all hear.
You can't hear?
No, your partner, we cannot listen to her properly. We cannot hear. She's far.
You can't hear at all?
Ah, no, we can hear someone. I think it's her.
Okay. Do you hear me talking?
Yes.
Okay. The question was the rice.
What kind of rice and is it best to use white? Hay una pregunta en el chat. Están preguntando qué tipo de arroz de usar y si es mejor usar arroz blanco.
Yes, yeah, you want to use long grain white rice. Okay, so then you're going to want to rinse out this water. And take out your cinnamon sticks because you don't need them currently.
Para preparar la mixtura de arroz, van a sacar la agua y también van a quitarle la canela entera.
Okay. So once you kind of just gave it like a quick rinse, you're going to then transfer it to your blender.
Okay. Cuando le quiten el agua que tenía, van a poner la mixtura en la licuadora, en el contenedor de la licuadora.
And some little pieces of cinnamon that I don't want in there. It wouldn't affect the flavor if you do keep your cinnamon in there. I just don't know how good of a blender you have or like the blade with it. So just to limit blender casualties, I take it out.
Y Jessica saca la canela entera porque no piensa que su licuadora va a poder hacerlo, mixtearlo bien. O sea, va a quedar mucha textura si deja la canela entera. Pero también depende de qué tipo de licuadora tiene.
Okay, and then you're going to have a cup of water or so off to the side because you're going to want to put some water in with your rice just so it does blend.
Para que se licue bien, van a agregar como una taza más o menos de agua a la licuadora.
And you can also mix a little bit of your canned evaporated milk just to give it more of like a milky flavor. But this will all go in afterwards as well if you don't want to do that. But I'm going to mix in just like about a tablespoon to a quarter cup.
Okay, y también le va a agregar un poco de leche evaporada, evaporated milk. What are you adding?
Evaporated milk, yeah.
Yeah. Va a agregar como unas cucharadas de leche evaporada. Someone in the chat said that this drink makes them think about a beverage that some people make with soft tofu.
Oh yeah, I've heard that. I haven't had it, but I have heard that that's a way to do some of those beverages. I think it's like an agua fresca.
I think they use, I don't remember, but a long time ago, I know that taking a class for childcare, we did something with a soft tofu, I don't know, and the almond milk, something like that, and the banana, I don't know, we are mixing some stuff like that.
Oh, that sounds delicious. I wonder if it was like a vegan milkshake.
Ah, yes, why you could enter in that. But it just, it's a far, it's not, I'm not a big fan of tofu, so I know that it's a way to drink it, to have that. Okay.
Okay, I'm going to mute myself while I blend this, because you don't need to have that on mic.
vamos a apagar el sonido por un momento mientras usa la licuadora.
So you're going to want to blend this until it's as smooth as you can get it. So I do it for about 2 minutes or a minute to 2 minutes, and I kind of gauge it. And then if it looks like it needs more blending, then I'll go for like another round, maybe add some more water.
Jessica, recomiendan que prendan la licuadora como por 1 o 2 minutos hasta que esté muy, muy, muy chiquita la mixtura.
Okay, so this, just eyeballing it, looks like it is like a thick milkshake. You don't want to drink it quite yet because it's going to be really gross and grainy. So that's when we're going to go in with our strainer. So you want to have a nice fine mesh strainer or some cheesecloth. I have a fine mesh strainer here. I'm just going to like pat it off real quick from the rice. Oh, Daisy translate.
So ya que está todo mezclada la mixtura, va a agarrar un colador. Porque tiene mucha textura todavía por el arroz y todos los partículos. Va a ser un colador para sacar el líquido que quedó y va a separar todo lo que todavía está entero.
Okay. So I'll come up to the camera so you can kind of see what it looks like. It just looks like a frothy milkshake right now, but it does have a lot of chunks in it. So we're going to want to take those away because we want a nice smooth drink, because no one really wants to drink something like this and have just like sandy bits come into their mouth. So we're just going to just very carefully strain this over. You don't have too much because you don't want it to spill on the sides of the table.
Cuidadosamente va a usar el colador para separar lo que está entero todavía de la mixtura de para la horchata.
So you can use your spoon and just kind of move things around because you'll see that it kind of stops draining a bit when it catches some of the sandy bits.
También recomienda que usen como una cuchara para mezclar la mezcla porque se atora si no lo mezcla.
It's a little there. Okay.
Y nada más lo está usted usando el colador porque no quiere que los granos del arroz se queden en la bebida.
Okay. And I know my abuelita didn't want to waste anything. So like usually the chunks that were caught in the strainer, she'll put back in the blender and go for another round of blending. So you can try to, I don't remember how well that actually worked, but she was happy with it.
Para que rinda la mixtura más, la abuelita de Jessica a veces ponía lo que quedaba de la mixtura ya después de usar el colador, lo regresaba a la licuadora y le ponía agua y lo licuaba otra vez. Jessica, we have a question. So when you added evaporated milk, was it the Sweet Eagle brand? Alguien tiene una pregunta de qué tipo de leche evaporada usó Jessica.
So it was the Carnation, the Nestle brand. So this is the kind of gap, but any evaporated milk can work.
Jessica usó la marca de Carnation que se ve en la pantalla, pero dice que cualquier leche evaporada sirve igual.
So once you get everything in here, sometimes the strainer doesn't get everything, so you might have some like bits at the bottom. You can go for another round up on the strainer. So then you're going to want to kind of have like another cup or something nearby and pour this into and then kind of strain it again once you clean out your strainer. I don't want, actually, I will go ahead and do that.
Okay, so esta parte es opcional, pero alguna gente prefiere colar la mixtura dos veces para sacar todos los granitos de arroz, pero es preferencia. No solamente nada más lo una vez, porque no quiere esperar tanto tiempo.
You can also like kind of double layer things with like cheesecloth. And that might help strain a little bit more. I've also done like a coffee filter. Get the chunky bits out.
Peggy, yes. So the recipe is available on the event page. And we will also be sending it out after the program. And there's the link to the event page in the chat.
Okay, so this is just kind of my quick second round where I'm just going to pour around.
I can do a quick recap of the ingredients if you like, Jess. Basically, you're going to need rice that you're going to soak overnight. Jessica uses 2 sticks of cinnamon. She uses about 2 cups of rice. She puts a dash, about a teaspoon of ground cinnamon in a container. What else am I missing?
Almonds.
Oh, and some blanched chopped almonds. And you're going to soak that overnight, minimum 8 hours. You can also go up to 12. You can really take it as long as you want. The rice has to be soaked. And then once it's ready, once it's soaked overnight, you're going to drain the mixture and then you're going to put it, the rice and everything, you're going to put it in the blender, take out the cinnamon sticks. You're going to blend that with some water and if you want, you can also add a little bit of evaporated milk at that stage. You're going to blend it and then you're going to strain it. And that's where we're at now.
Yep. Okay. And so now that you have your drink, I only made about like this much, but you also got to remember you're adding extra liquids to this. So now we're going to want to add the rest of our evaporated milk.
Okay. So ya que tienes la mixtura concentrada, ahorita va a adelar leche evaporada. Is it the whole can?
So I didn't do the full 2 cups that I talked about when I blended. So I only did about like half a can.
Okay, como esta jarra está un poco chiquita, nada más uso media taza. Pero también cuánta leche evaporada depende de qué tan grande va a ser tu jarra.
Okay, and then so this is just something that my abuelita did. Most recipes don't call for this, but I used sweetened condensed milk. It is a lot thicker, but it also gives it a sweetness that I don't have to put as much sugar then afterwards. So I'm going to open up this can. I'm only doing about a half, but if you make this full batch, you're going to want to do the full 2 cans.
Y ahora va a usar leche condensada. So esto es la preferida. Esto es lo que prefería, usar la abuela de Jessica en vez de azúcar para endulzar la horchata. So, sí puedes usar azúcar, ella va a usar como es poquita horchata, nada más va a usar como media taza para endulzarlo. Y ahora la van a mezclar todo junto.
And I'm just using my giant cinnamon stick to stir it because you're going to want to put some more cinnamon sticks in to give more flavor. And then you're going to have about a tablespoon of almond extract, if I can get this one open. Carlos.
Okay, y ahorita, so. Ahorita adherió una canela entera. porque lo va a dejar que se remoje en
Thank you.
La horchata y también va a añadir un poquito de extracto de almendras para el sabor, como para la receta entera como una cucharada y para este yo creo como una cucharadita.
Okay, so you're going to want to do about like a half a tablespoon to a tablespoon. I'm going to do a half for right now. I don't want it to be too vanilla-y and too overpowering. So then you're just going to give it a good stir. And so by now it looks like a nice thick melted down ice cream. And so then you're going to want to go in and add some more water to it.
Ahorita lo que tiene en la jarra está un poco espeso y lo va a agregar agua.
And water is just kind of eyeballed in there. You want to do like 1 to 2 cups.
So puedes agregar como 1 o 2 tazas. También depende de cómo prefieres tú la horchata, la consistencia.
Okay, and this is when you kind of want to go in and do your little taste test.
Y so, ya cuando estás aquí vas a querer probar cómo está la horchata para el sabor.
Okay, so then if it is not sweet enough, that's when you're going to go in and add some more sugar. Usually I boil a little bit of water and then I will put the sugar in a little bit of water and put like the water in like as a syrup because it helps melt it. But I'm going to do a little taste test of what I have. And granted, this will taste much better with ice, but I don't have any ice right now. But this is meant to be a cold drink. I'll just put a little bit.
Okay, ahora va a probar cómo está la horchata para ver qué le falta.
Oh, that's nice. I personally don't feel like it needs to be any sweeter because that condensed milk gives it a lot of sugar. But I'll see what our cameraman thinks as an horchata connoisseur.
Aren't we all horchata connoisseurs when you grew up with it? You can just tell. Like,
I
can definitely tell at the restaurants when it's like fresh made horchata or when it's from the powdered mix.
Mm-hmm.
It's just a difference in flavor.
There's like a flavor and a texture difference too. Mm-hmm. So I would probably think to add just like a little bit more water because it is still like a little thick, even though I don't mind it being kind of milkshakey.
Dice que está todavía un poco espeso, solo va a añadir un poquito más de agua.
And then it will water down too with more ice that you add to for your drink. So
también,
you want to think about that.
Y cuando, como este refresco se toma con hielo, el hielo se va a derritir. So también tienen que pensar eso cuando están bebiendo la agua.
Okay. And that's the horchata as it is semi-traditionally made.
So esta es como una receta muy, muy básica, muy simple de... horchata.
Yes. So for those that are vegan and don't want to use any of the evaporated milks or the condensed milks, almond milk is a great thing to use. You can get like the sweetened kind too. Just add a little bit more sweet. And then also they have like a vanilla flavoring too. So you wouldn't have to put as much vanilla as well. And yes, instead of using those, you would just use more of the almond milk and then just combine water with it. Or just almond milk if you want it kind of thicker. So those are some options.
Okay. We have a comment from Grace and some questions. Actually, I worry about the sweetness of the Eagle brand milk. Do you think it will taste good to us who don't like a lot of sweetness without it? Grace tiene una pregunta sobre la leche evaporada y si va a adherir mucha, si va a estar muy dulce la receta y para los que prefieren algo menos dulce.
Yes, yeah, so you don't have to use the condensed milk for if you don't want it as sweet. In my opinion, I don't think the sweetened condensed milk actually adds too much sweetness to it. Sometimes I've had to add more sugar to it. But yeah, you can totally do it without it. Just almond milk is totally fine.
Mm-hmm.
And then just add as much sugar, like real sugar that you're wanting in it for however sweetness that you want.
When you're making it yourself, you can easily control the like the sweetness. So cuando estás haciendo la horchata tú mismo, puedes controlar todos los sabores y qué tan dulce está. Pero tradicionalmente este sí es una bebida más dulce que otras. Oh, we have a comment, Jessica. Somebody really likes your apron. Alguien le gusta mucho el mandil de Jessica.
Oh, thank you very much. My friend's sister made it for me. I felt like it was very fitting and it kind of channeled my abuelita when she was in the kitchen.
Dice que usó un mandil hoy porque le recuerda mucho de cuando su abuela cocinaba. Porque ella también usaba un mandil.
All right, so now that we have our tata made, and I feel like it's sweet enough for me, we're going to go into actually some cooking stuff. So I'm going to show you my recipe for pumpkin spice syrup. So I do like to put about like a teaspoon of this pumpkin spice in my horchata for like a nice fall kind of beverage. I put it in my coffee. I've also used horchata to sweeten my coffee when I make a lot of horchata, and I have like a nice horchata coffee. It's really good.
Did you try with tea?
I haven't yet, but I've been wanting to try it with Earl Grey, like a nice black tea.
Yes.
Okay, y ahora va a preparar una, se dice, como una, hold on.
I'm just gonna prep while Daisy remembers a word in Spanish, I think.
Dice almíbar la traducción, pero es como una mixtura para de sabor, para endulzar, con las esas especies de otoño, o pumpkin spice en inglés.
And I'm doing like a cooking no-no. I'm not cleaning up as I like am moving and doing stuff. So I'll just clean up after this. but yes, yeah, so for our pumpkin spice stuff, I did not bring the ingredients over here. Pardon me. They're probably pretty simple ingredients. You're going to want to have your brown sugar. I do light brown sugar.
Okay, y estos son los ingredientes que voy a usar. La azúcar morena.
Cinnamon, ground cinnamon.
Canela molida.
Puree pumpkin or pumpkin puree. I just get this can.
Puré de calabaza.
And then you're going to want to have your pumpkin spice seasoning. I don't know. Spices, yeah, like your pumpkin spices. So they come pre-made. I make my own because it's just cheaper. And it's only, and I can tell you like what all it is.
También tiene la mixtura de especias que son de las de pumpkin spice. Y ahorita nos va a decir qué tiene. Ella hace sus especias, su mezcla ella misma. Pero también puedes usar una que ya está hecha en la tienda.
Yeah. And then so just like briefly real quick, just what the pumpkin spice is for making this mix. It's just your ground nutmeg. Ground cinnamon, ground ginger, cloves. I get some whole cloves and just kind of like mash them up just because they're cheaper than getting them pre-ground. And then you just kind of mix it all together. So I can send the actual recipe of like the measurements out to you, everyone, if they want to do it themselves, or you can just buy the pre-done one.
Okay, so los ingredientes que usa para hacer el pumpkin spice es nuez moscada, canela molida, clavos.
Nutmeg.
Yes. Y es todo. Pero también se puede comprar ya hecho en las tiendas. Usualmente venden ese mentado pumpkin spice.
Yeah, and all those combined just makes your pumpkin spice stuff. And I like sprinkling a lot of this in my coffee or also just on the horchata without the syrup too. So we're gonna get started with going to the stove. So you wanna follow me to the stove. Oh, Okay, so you're going to want a saucepan or a skillet. I prefer a skillet, but what I have here is just like a regular pan.
Y ahora va a ser el almíbar de pumpkin spice. So en una olla.
Okay, and you're going to do 2 cups of brown sugar.
So vas a agregar a la olla 2 tazas de azúcar morena.
And then you get your 2 cups in there with about 1 cup of water.
Y vas a agregar 1 taza de agua.
And you want 1 cup of your pumpkin puree.
Y 1 taza de puré de papa. In the chat, somebody suggested maybe using honey instead of condensed milk. You could definitely try that.
Yeah, that's true. I haven't tried that. I definitely want to try that now.
Yeah.
Sounds like it would add like a nice natural sweetness too.
Yeah. I think the reason, so condensed milk is like a really popular like ingredient in Mexican like sweets. Mm. And it's also like got a milky flavor, which is why I think it works really well with arroz con leche. It does work in arroz con leche, but in horchata. Because it just amplifies the sort of milkiness of the that rice mixture that you make. All right, so now she's gonna stir. So ahorita va a mezclar todo en la olla.
So you wanna cook this down and it's going to make like a syrup. While that's getting nice and mixed, you wanna add 1 tablespoon of your cinnamon.
Okay, so vas a dejar que se caliente. Quieres hacer como un almíbar. So vas a dejar que se de, is it gonna like a soft boil?
Yeah. You don't want it too hot, you don't want it to burn.
Okay, so no, para que no se queme, nada más lo van a calentar hasta que empiece a, I know the word. Boil. Hasta que empiece a hervir. So no quieren que hierva mucho.
Yeah. You want to keep stirring it.
Okay, y también le adhirió como 1 cucharada de canela molida. Y asegúrense de que no paren de mezclar todos los ingredientes. No quieren que se pegue o también, okay, hierva, que se queme.
Okay, and then also add about 1 tablespoon. Actually, I'm probably going to do about 2 tablespoons of pumpkin spice.
Okay, y también, ya ahora va a adherir como 2 cucharadas de pumpkin spice, de esa mixtura que hizo ella.
And then you're just going to keep mixing it until it gets into a nice, like, syrupy texture. So all this sugar and everything should melt down. And if it's too thick, you can add more water. And this is kind of it right now. You can kind of see it's a little thick, but not that thick. And if you like pumpkin-y flavor, like more, you can add a little bit more pumpkin. I don't like pumpkin, but I like this pumpkin spice syrup. So I just pretend I don't have pumpkin in it.
So, ¿quieren que esta mixtura se haga un poco espesa? Pero si piensan que está muy espesa, también pueden agregar un poquito de agua para que esté más liso. Nada, depende de cómo lo quieren.
Okay, and as it cooks down, it'll get thicker and thicker. And then you'll have, this is some stuff I've made previously. So and it kind of gets like that. And you just kind of like add a little dollop of it as you need it.
Okay, y esto es como se va a mirar la mixtura ya cuando esté todo así en espeso, ya que esté listo. Y cuánto Y so ya cuando quieren añadir un poquito de su pumpkin spice, agarran como una cucharadita y se lo agregan a la horchata. Y tienen pumpkin spice horchata.
You can hear me stirring it. So the syrup definitely melts a little bit easier when it's in hot, something hot. So sometimes I have like my ice cold horchata, I'll put like a little bit of hot water at the bottom, do the pumpkin spice first, let it kind of melt down. And then I'll add all my horchata and my ice, and it's so delicious. But that's the pumpkin spice syrup. You can use it pretty much on anything. It's really good with any sort of sweets. Now I want to try this out with a tea. I do have a bunch of jasmine tea. I wonder if that would be too overpowering, like a pumpkin spice jasmine.
Y también dice que, bueno, ella preparó esta pumpkin spice al almíbar para la horchata de hoy, pero también se puede usar en otras bebidas como va tratar de usarlo con un té, pero yo creo también en un café. Oh, there's a question about the pumpkin spice. Does it need to be refrigerated? How long does it last?
So it does need to be refrigerated, and it can last for about a month in a jar.
Okay.
So you want to have it as airtight as you can.
Okay. Alguien tenía una pregunta si necesitan poner esta pumpkin spice en el refrigerador. Y Jessica dice que tiene que estar refrigerado y puede durar en el refri como hasta un mes, pero tiene que estar en un contenedor que no deja que entrar el aire. So tiene que estar muy bien cerrado.
And that's pretty much it. You can add it to anything. Your horchata is good for any time of the year. I do advise it being iced. I haven't really had it hot because I don't think it would do well hot, but whatever floats your boat.
All right. So esas son las recetas de hoy. Si alguien tiene unas preguntas, por favor, póngalas en el chat. If anybody has any questions for Jess before we end, go ahead and type them in the chat or unmute and you can chat. Now that it's getting into the fall season and getting a little colder, you could also make a dirty horchata. Yeah, like a shot of espresso.
Yeah. Well, yeah, I said I put the horchata in my coffee.
Yeah.
As like the milk.
Oh, that sounds really good.
Or the cream. Especially since it's so thick the way that I make it, it's really good.
Yeah. Yeah, but definitely please try making horchata. Tag us in your pictures on like Instagram or Facebook if you do.
Tag the library. Yeah. We'd love to see it.
Por favor, traten la receta si la hacen y la ponen en su sus cuentas de SNS de Facebook o de Instagram, por favor. Háganos un tag a la biblioteca pública. Thanks for joining us, everybody.
Yeah, thank you. Hope you enjoyed it and hope you enjoy this recipe as much as I did growing up, and I still do today. So thank you, everyone.